Welcome to the Internet Governance Forum in Guadalajara, Mexico in 2016. We're just about to do our workshop on enhancing cultural and linguistic diversity online.
I think that the industry is more prepared for IDNs. We have seen some uptakes in IDNs, both at the top and the second level, but there is still much work to be done, especially in the universal acceptance area. And also in the education and awareness of people about IDNs.
But if you don't have domain names in different languages and different scripts, how do you start? So I think that's an essential part. But of course, that won't suffice. But then where is the content? You give out domain names ad infinitum. Where is relevant content so that people find an incentive?
And for the last 6 years, we have been tracking the development of internationalized domain names and how they are used and how they signal multilingual content online.
Well, I'd say the youth nowadays communicate with their peers using social media. Websites still remain absolutely a valuable source of knowledge, entertainment. I know that several youth they watch TV online. So I talked to a few who are keeping up with their favorite series here in Mexico via websites. So absolutely, domain names still hold a relevance for the youth.
There are about 6,000 languages which are spoken officially in the world, out of which a few hundred are online. And English and Chinese have more than 50% of the content online. So when we talk about issues of access, I think we're just missing the point. Because if I come from a country like India, if you give connectivity to a farmer in a rural area, number one, there's no content in his own language, and then number two, there's no locally relevant content.
Internationalized domain names are an internet governance issue because we all have to do more to promote multilingualism online. It is one of our fundamental rights to be able to speak and express ourselves in our own language and to be able to find content that is locally understandable and relevant. And therefore, it should be of interest to all policymakers to understand both the benefits of an internationalized domain name space and also the challenges that are still faced, which stand in the way of mass uptake.